And welcome to Smart.
Mark, have you seen the state of the studio? It's falling to pieces.
I know, it's terrible, isn't it? Have you seen this over here? Look.
Look at the size of that. Hang on. This has been painted on. This is a trick. Do you know anything about this?
Well, all right. See, it is for art's sake, you see. It's a little technique I've been perfecting called trompe l'oeil.
Oh.
Follow me, I'll show you. And mind the hole.
That's massive. That's another trick, isn't it? Mark!
Yeah, sorry about that, Kirsten. It's another trompe l'oeil or trick of the eye. Now, here's a bit of fun you can have creating exposed brickwork. Now, as you can see, I've already started on one down here. I've got to make it look very, very realistic. So, I'm using a sponging technique, you see.
Okay.
Slightly sponge on different tones of the brickwork, just very lightly, like so, you see? So you build up different layers. We'll get another one in there as well. There we go, just put another bit in there. You see, and you start making the brickwork look very realistic. Not only that, you want to work out where your light source is coming from. Now, the light's shining from above, so the bricks under here are going to be in shadow. So if I just put a slightly darker tone underneath here, okay, just there, you see? Just drag it across.
Oh, yeah.
You see, it looks like it's actually sitting in shadow there.
Yeah.
Which is nice. So all you have to do then is work your whole page, building it up in colour, and then when you've done that, cut it out. We'll just put this one under here. Right, like this. Lightly tack the back of it, stick it onto the wall, and look at this. What a giggle. That's great, isn't it?
You see? Looks cool.
Not only that, look, I've got this one here, look. Is it a light switch?
I don't know.
No, it's a trick of the eye. Completely flat.
That looks amazing.
It's cool, isn't it? And, look, a little fly up there. Again, a little trompe l'oeil fly. And a handprint, which is literally just painted onto paper, cut out, and then stuck onto the wall.
So you look like you've had your hands all over the wallpaper.
Exactly.
I've got a bit of a trick as well. Look at this nice old painting in a very old frame. And this started life as a cereal box with the back completely cut away from it and the front, a little rectangle cut out for your picture to go in. And then all I did was decorate it, and it's very nicely done, just really simply with rope, well, string, all the way around in a pattern, and then the inner and outer edges done as well, and then paint the whole thing gold. Then all you need to do is come up with a picture that'll fit in there. I did the sunflowers, so if I come back to that, you can see. It looks lovely, doesn't it, Mark? But
yes.
It has a little trick, because...
Where's the trick?
Inside... I've been storing secret things away from you that you didn't know about.
But and now all, I know about them.
Yes, the back is just made from a slightly smaller cereal box with, again, just one side almost completely cut out. Just leave a little edge and then you can keep everything in there. Pop it on the wall. Nobody knows what's inside it. That is a real hook there, isn't it?
I don't know, is it?
Put it on. There you go.
Very good, Kirst.
I'm
like
loving
it.
This trick art thing.
Yes, actually, you should see the amount of fun I had when I painted a £10 note on the floor. Some of those reactions are brilliant, and capturing people's expressions in cartoons is even more fun. Let me show you. For instance, if you're happy, all your expressions, your face lifts up like so. Yeah? So what you want to do is try and capture that in a picture. So basically just do a nice smiley face and lift your eyebrows. Lovely. If you're sad, your face becomes very heavy, so your features drop. So let's put that in there. Look. Heavy frown, sad face, even a little tear. If you're angry, your face screws up. Okay, so what you do there is screw the mouth up, drop the eyebrows. This chap is really looking very angry. If you're worried, your features go, your lips purse. So all your features come forward. So here we go. Little nose. And look. Ooh. He's very worried. And if you're scared, all your face just explodes and goes mad. So your hair sticks up on end. Right, here we go. Your mouth is a gasp. There you go. Now, the trick is to keep as many features as you can in a notebook and use them for reference. Now, what I want you to do at home is to see this little chappy here who's having absolute fits of giggles, right? He's laughing. Look, his eyes are screwed up. His mouth's wide open. He's having a right laugh. Excellent. Now, what I want you guys at home to do is to draw what this chap is laughing at. You can download this image from your PC at www.bbc.co.uk/CBBC. Click on art and you'll find all the smart stuff there. Now, here's someone who always makes me laugh. It's Morph.
Impressions. It's time to have a look in our book.
Oh, yes, time to take a look at your work in our gallery. Oh, look at Bethan's patchwork scarecrow.
I'm going to be very positive about Daniel's picture because half of it is in the negative.
I like that. Jessica's watercolour landscape is very colourful, isn't it?
Look at Leanne's picture here. She's really getting the hang of perspective. Show your picture in our gallery, you will get yourself a set of our smart watercolour pencils and a smart sketchbook to go with it.
Yes, I'm sorry we can't return any of your work, but do keep it coming in because we love it. The address will be shown at the end of the programme.
I'll tell you what, if you fancy exhibiting your art, have you thought about a public exhibition? Sounds like a tall order? Well, it is worth it. Have a look at what this lot achieved.
I used to think that galleries were pretty unexciting places, but that has changed.
We're from Bessemer Grange Primary School.
And in just 2 weeks' time, we children will be holding our own art exhibition right here in Dulwich Picture Gallery.
We're organising it ourselves and we want you to come to the launch.
But first, let us show you our video diary of the artists in action. That's us.
Today, we're learning how paint was made hundreds of years ago. I see
we're using earth to make brown paint. So beautiful,
won't you come with me? This is copper pipe and it was put into vinegar and it turned into this turquoisey bluey colour. World, so beautiful, won't you come with me?
to Desmond, and he's the one who gives important speeches at exhibitions, and we need his advice for our speeches.
Now, there are three things you need to do with speeches. First, it's got to be short, so otherwise people get bored. But the second one, don't speak too quickly. So really slow yourself down. Then the third thing is remember to thank everyone. Best of luck. I mean, I hope it goes well. I'm sure it will.
Thanks very much.
You're welcome.
Phew, we've done loads, but we've still got catering, marketing and t-shirt making.
We are the catering committee and we've got some shopping to do.
Now we've got some cooking to do. Let's bake.
Our pictures are being hung up on the wall, ready for the art exhibition tomorrow.
Hi guys, I'm Ellie and I've been involved in hanging the exhibition. What do you think?
Pretty good.
How did you choose the pictures?
Well, as you know, everyone had a different technique in the classes and we picked the biggest and the boldest and the best from each of the classes.
Was it difficult?
No, it actually was a really nice exhibition to hang, I have to say.
How long did it take to hang all the pictures?
It took about 2 days in total, but we've actually still got a little bit to do, and I was wondering if you guys would help me.
After months of planning and preparation, it's finally launch night. The Wonderful Pictures exhibition opens its doors to the public.
During the past 6 months, we've been doing art with specialists and we've been concentrating on portraits and self-portraits.
Now, I mean, I have just been knocked out by what I've seen, haven't you all? I mean, it is absolutely extraordinary. Congratulations, children, to all of you for what you've achieved here. It is quite extraordinary.
We'd like to say thank you to Desmond, the director, and to all of you for coming, and we hope you enjoy it.
Look at all this amazing artwork. I tell you what, those guys were talented. They even produced their own T-shirts, and the opening night looked fantastic. Yeah, my invitation must have been lost in the post. Yeah. Anyway, here's a way to create your own installation. Now, first of all, you will need one of these chocolate boxes. In fact, you won't need one, you'll need six, to which you then stick or mount onto a bit of board so they're nice and secure. You then get two pictures that you want to play around with. Now, I've got one of me here as a dinosaur hunter and one of these two dinosaurs. Well, in fact, they're not real dinosaurs, they're just toys that I, you know, photograph. Anyhow, what you have to do then is to cut your photograph into strips. Just show you here, like I've done here. OK, now, it's very crucial, this. They've got to be exactly the same width as your chocolate box. You do that all the way along, six times. You do the same with the other picture, OK? You then literally stick them onto the side of your box. Where are you? Like this. Where's my other strip? I'll just put that one on there. Come on, son, that's it. Just put it down there like that. Stick him on. And check this out, right? You watch what happens. When I literally put him to the side like that, you see Dinosaur Hunter, and then slowly it morphs into the dinosaur. Isn't that excellent? Look, again, Dinosaur Hunter into dinosaurs. It's absolutely magic. And look, I'll show you this other one here I've got of Kirsten. Look, here's little Kirsten. There you go. Can you see little Kirsten? Look, ah, oh, isn't she sweet? And look, she turns into a little flower. There you go. Once more. Aren't they great?
I am loving this idea, Mark. Yeah. Especially the fact that you have to empty the chocolate boxes first. Mm. Right. Really demonstrates how things aren't always quite what they seem.
No, that's right. They're not. Are they?
see young man one way, old man the other. Like it, Marky. You know, lots of elements can influence the way we see things. For example, this silly hole here. I'm sure it only tricked me because of these warning barriers around it. But if I get rid of these... Here we go. All out of the way. Now, you can see... That hole looks far less dramatic without its frame, doesn't it? I've got this smashing picture of Mark Speight, and what it needs is a frame. So I'm going to make one for it right away. All you need are four of these. These are like cling film boxes, or you get them with foil in them. And all you need, as I say, are four of them, three of which I've already attached together like that. I'm just going to add the last one by PVA gluing two globs onto the top, wee, like that, and adding my last one. Now, you need to leave that somewhere to dry, and once it's dried, you need to paint it completely white so that it'll look like this. Now, I need to decorate this. So what I've got is some PVA glue, but with a nozzle, because I'm actually going to kind of pipe it on like I'm icing a cake. So let's just start up here. There we go. Nice kind of curve. Woo! Like that. I might just retouch that. And you just need to do nice kind of curves and swirls and anything that looks like you might find on quite an ornate frame. Once you've done that all the way around and you've left it to dry, it'll look like that one there. Starting to look like an old frame now, but what it needs is an old colour. I'm going to make it gold, so I've got some lovely gold paint here. And just slap that on. It's a great colour, isn't it? And you can see where the glue has dried, you can start to see that kind of edging now. You need to do that all the way around and, again, leave that to dry so that when you get to this stage, it's looking good, but it's looking very new. It's looking very, very shiny. And I've got a top tip for getting rid of all that shine. This is just ordinary shoe polish and I've got a cloth. And all I'm going to do, get a load on my cloth and rub it on. And you'll see it catches in all those raised areas and just makes it look a bit grubby, a bit old, and really brings out that gilt edge. So you need to do that all the way around. Once that's done, you can just add your picture to it, making sure that it fits. And look what I've done to lovely Mr. Speight. Now, he looks great, doesn't he? A proper frame for a proper portrait. But you could change the frame and things all look totally different. There is a frame with all Mark's favourite things around it. I've customised it. It's kind of boy frame. Or I've done quite a modern frame there with lots of, like, cuttings of foil paper on it and a really kitsch one up the back. It's just wild, really bright colours. So you can see, same picture, lots of different frames. Gives it a totally different feel.
Hey, Kirs, come over here.
What are you up to, Marky?
Mind you,
what's going on?
I'm colouring in.
Oh,
I need a hand.
I got, yes, I hope you say that. Where do you want me?
Well, I've got all the paints laid out over there, so dive in. You can work quite close to the edge as well, because you won't see it when you come round the other side, Kirst.
Is it we're making?
Not telling you. Surprise.
Cartoony, Mark.
I'll tell you what, it'll look great when it all comes together.
What, that's it?
No, there's another stage. Follow me. Right, I think we've got to do some cutting now, so file this one. Still, you just cut it down.
Up there?
Yep. Yeah. Lovely.
You got it?
Straight down there. Right. Flip it over.
Oh, I see. Like a bit of a jigsaw puzzle.
Yeah, you get it now. Here's the next one. Nice, line it up. Hang on. Good.
Oh, I get it, a fruit bowl.
Yeah, you see.
Very impressive illusion, Mark. We can be proud of that. Although you're not too proud of your hole now, I'd imagine, because it doesn't look half as realistic without the barriers, does it?
Curse, you just have to use your imagination. Anyway, I think it looks great!
Mark! Mark, you up? Oh, dear. See you soon. Bye.
Hey, Curse, look. I found 10p. Bye!
Don't forget you can send your pictures to us at Smart, PO Box 5053, London W12 6AW. Fact sheets for today's show can be found on the website www.bbc.co.uk/CBBC. For the best in art, stick with Smart.
Would this island look like paradise if you had to bail out of a helicopter to get there? 3 weeks, 10 adventurers, and one island with a mind of its own. Ah! Who will win the race to escape?
Oh, no!
Here we go! Amazing!
Scorpion Island, paradise with a sting in its tail. Starts today at 5, CBBC on BBC One.